It all started with the Mauryas, who ruled over Bidar in the 3rd century. Back then, bamboo plants were found in plenty. It is why the town of Bidar was given its original name, Bidiru or Bidaruru. Over the years, this name morphed into Bidar. Set in the heart of the Deccan, and thanks to its pleasant climate, Bidar was home to many rulers and dynasties. Prior to the establishment of the Bahamani Sultanate, the older fort at Bidar was held by the Tughlaq dynasty of Delhi. It was captured in 1322 by Ulugh Khan, who later became famous as Muhammad bin Tughlaq. After the establishment of the Bahamani Sultanate, this fort was made impregnable. In 1429, they moved their capital from Gulbarga to Bidar. The massive moats you see around the fort's walls were constructed by the Bahamanis. The fort of Bidar, built on the edge of the plateau, has had various architects and engineers from across the world work on its design. The one thing that is sure to strike you about the fort is the sheer size of it. Spread over a massive 775 acres, this fort could take all day to explore. Though parts of the fort are dilapidated, much of it remains largely intact.